ओम शांति। फर्स्ट मार्च, इंग्लिश अव्यक्त मुरली। रिवाइज डेट 5th February 79। टॉपिक बाप दादाज हार्ट टू हार्ट कन्वर्सेशन विद द मधुबन रेसिडेंट्स। टुडे बाबा है स्पेशली कम टू मीट यू स्पेशली फॉर्चुनेट सोल्स हु लिव ऑन द स्पेशल लैंड दैट हैज अ स्पेशल मेमोरियल टू द ग्रेट पिलग्रिमेज प्लेस of which even the devotees of today still sing praise. This land is so powerful that all the waste of all the many souls stops as soon as they come here. They all become powerful and easily attain many types of treasures of experience. This land is such that you can attain whatever blessings you want on the basis of remembrance and of the land itself. So, what would the residents of this land themselves be? Even today, devotees are desperate to have a view of this divine and elevated land. So, are the people living on this land the images that grant visions? Is your stage equal to the importance of the land or is the praise of the land greater? If those who live far away become powerful just by keeping the awareness of Madhuban, then what would the residents of Madhuban themselves be? Are you as great as the importance given to Madhuban? Madhuban is a bhandara, treasure store of all subtle and physical attainments. So, in accordance with that, do all of you consider your speed and stage to be just as elevated? Are you residents of Madhuban, embodiments of success? According to the easy methods you have of the facilities, the company, the cooperation of the importance of the land and atmosphere. Years have passed. This year has also passed. The new year has begun. And 1 month of that has already passed. So, what was the result of your experience of 1 month? Did you experience the ascending stage? Did you accumulate something at every step? That is, was every step powerful? Were you able to destroy all your own obstacles and the obstacles of others? Now that the time is coming close, you need to receive marks in all four subjects. Everyone says the same thing of you, that you all serve everyone very well, sevadharis. However, you all have to be filled with knowledge, yoga and dharana. Just as people experience heaven from the total atmosphere here, so too each one of you should also feel that you are living in heaven, that you are an embodiment of all attainments. In everything you do, as you move around, you should all be seen by others as angels. Acha, signals for service. This year, bring people from all the professions into contact with you. Let them be in connection with you in such a way that as soon as you give them a signal, they are able to accomplish that task through your authority. Generally, you make contact with them as and when you need them, and then that contact becomes a little distant. However, you must now increase that connection. Just as in the beginning, you had the aim of wanting to create everyone's fortune. So now, keep the aim of taking cooperation from souls of all professions by making contact with them and using them as instruments for special service. At present, there are souls of the average quality, but eventually, you have to reach everyone. So, now, such special souls should emerge that many others will be able to receive the message from one. Only when Everyone has zeal and enthusiasm. Will a queue form this year? Service of this quality should take place. Since there is the title, Father of the World, there has to be variety in the world. Even if someone is an atheist, you definitely must still make contact with him. All types of seeds are needed to make the new world. Only then will you be able to become world benefactors. Religious and political leaders should at least accept that your methods and your transformation are very good. When religious leaders experience this, they will give their cooperation. Achha, Baap Dada, meeting teachers. Are all of your teachers special servants? That is, are you those who reveal the Father through your words and deeds? To reveal the Father is the task of all of you spiritual servants. Whatever you have done so far, number wise, according to your capacity, has been very good. However, up to now, the result has been that only a few souls have experienced all of you to be great souls, to be souls with great lives. Now, even though they do speak about you, what still remains? The Father made the lives of all of you children worthwhile and put you ahead, and so you sing praise of your lives. But what is the duty of you children? The Father is the backbone and is playing his part in an incognito way. Therefore, you have to reveal the Father. People recognize those who are speaking, but as yet, the one who has made your lives worthwhile is still incognito. So, you now have to reveal the one who has made you as you are. That is, you have to fly the flag of victory. When you go onto the stage, you become merged in the Father's love and an embodiment of all attainment. In a worldly way, when a person is lost in love for someone, you can tell from his or her face, eyes and words that one is lost in love. Similarly, when you go onto a stage or platform, the more love you have for the Father in an immersed form, the more that love will emerge from within you, and this air of love will knock them out. Your form should not be of having to think of a thread in your lecture or of remembering points to make, but it should be that of an embodiment of love and one who has attained everything. You should have that authority. When you have authority in a particular subject, you don't have to think about it. You would have already thought it out. You would have churned the explanation of the topic very clearly in your intellect before you came onto the stage. You should not have to pay attention to churning it at that time. If you have prepared the topic very well, you will then speak on that topic as an authority. If you just keep on thinking about a point, you will not be experienced to be an authority. First, you have to be an embodiment of love and attainment. Secondly, when you begin to speak, the Father's praise should come from the authority within you. The sound should come from deep within your heart. For example, when it is Shivratri, that is the day of the Father's revelation. That is called the godly bomb, which means that whatever is merged within you should be visible to everyone. That is the explosion of the bomb. What happens to people when there is an explosion? Everyone is burned in the fire. So, this godly bomb is a bomb of love, a bomb of forging a relationship, a bomb of singing praise from your heart. The fire of being lost in love for Baba should shake everyone. When a bomb explodes,
everyone is shaken. So, everyone's intellect should be shaken as to the one whose praise this is. They should realize with which authority you are speaking, what message you are giving, and whose message you are giving. As well as authority, there should also be sweetness. Your words should be sweet, but at the same time, let there be authority within the self. Your words should be filled with feelings of mercy. You should continue to be singing the Father's praise and making everything clear for them. But while you are doing that, you should also be forging them into a relationship with the Father. Every now and then, you should be adding a few words of your own experience, such as, why am I telling you this? How would you benefit from this? What have I experienced? What is the experience of 1 second's attainment? They should not experience your talk to be just like a lecture, but they should experience your stage to be that of someone who is lost in love. In other words, that this is something new. Others say things, but those people are not embodiments of the things they say. Whereas, your form should be in accordance with your words. You and your words should be very clear, loving, humble, sweet, and filled with greatness and truth. You should be very humble. It is by having this form that you will reveal the Father. You should be fearless, but the words you speak should be disciplined and within the code of conduct. The two should be balanced. People will be able to see wonders when there is this balance. Those words will not seem bitter, but very sweet. So, now, show them this wonder of the balance of your authority and humility. This is known as the means of revealing Father. Just see with how much authority people speak when they speak of even the false scriptures. They are able to show something which is completely false to be completely true. Not only do they show that to be true, but they are also able to make you accept it as the truth. They are able to persuade you that whatever versions they speak are true. Those with the authority of something false are able to create such an influence, whereas the words you speak are the words of experience and the words of an embodiment of all attainments. The things you speak about come from having a relationship with the Father. So now, is it that you can't make others accept what you say to be the truth? Do you understand what you now have to do? You have to make Baba's introduction very clear for them. First, relate a point of knowledge and draw their attention to the Father. Then, while relating more points of knowledge, also continue to draw their attention to the Father, repeatedly pouring the water of love under the stone. Only then will you melt that stone. As much as possible, there should be an impact of silence. Everything must be very spiritual, simple, and clean. Everything must be filled with the vibrations of spirituality and purity. Even the Brahmin souls who are listening and cooperating should have the thought of creating the right atmosphere. Just as incense sticks are able to transform the atmosphere, so the merciful attitude of all of you Brahmin souls should work like incense sticks. As soon as people enter, they will feel your gathering to be spiritual. Acha, then when it's over, they will leave your gathering of love with their aprons, filled with love, and will then share that love with everyone. The love you have for the Father will make you such an embodiment of love that everyone who sees your face and behavior will only see the Father's love. You are celebrating such a meeting, are you not? A snehi milan, gathering of love, means to cooperate by having the determination to transform oneself and to transform everyone else. This is the speciality of a snehi milan. A snehi milan means a meeting of sanskars in a practical way. When you meet someone, your hands meet, whereas this meeting is a meeting of sanskars. When everyone's sanskars become the same as the father's, when everyone has the same sanskar, what will happen? The world of one kingdom and religion will arrive. Your unity here will become the basis of bringing about the world of one kingdom and one religion. A snehi milan means to end all complaints and to live here having become complete. All your complaints and you become very enthusiastic. This is what a snehi milan means. Bab Dada meeting double foreigners. Bab Dada is happy to see all the children who remain absorbed in love. What is the sign of those who remain constantly absorbed in love? Souls who are absorbed in love don't need to make effort to stay in remembrance, but are naturally yogi. They see nothing but the father and service. When the intellect finds its destination, it stops wandering. A soul who is lost in love would be absorbed in all the attainments he has received and remain busy in enabling other souls to receive the same attainments. Therefore, such souls would always be conquerors of Maya. Are you lost in love or do you have to make effort? The experience of souls living a special yogi life abroad especially can make them embodiments of success in service abroad. When you make your stage powerful, that is, when you become an embodiment of all the attainments you have experienced, you will become an embodiment of success, because day by day, souls with various desires will come in front of you. So, only when you have become an embodiment of all attainments, will you be able to become someone who fulfills the desires of others. Everyone will come searching for you, master bestowers of peace and happiness, and wonder where you are. Only when you are fully stocked with all powers will you be able to make everyone content. Abroad, they have supermarkets where you can buy whatever you want from one store. You have to become the same as those. It shouldn't be that you have the power to tolerate, but you don't have the power to face. You need to be stocked with all powers. Only then will you become an embodiment of success. Now, make the atmosphere of serving through the mind even more powerful abroad, because all the various souls there have to be impressed by your atmosphere. Only when they are first pulled by your vibrations will they then be able to listen to this knowledge. In order to serve through your mind, you must constantly practice maintaining stability and concentration. Only when all your vestige has finished will you be able to serve through your mind. When you leave Madhuban, take back with you a powerful experience of serving through the mind by having practiced it here. Anyone who sees you should experience you to be a mind of powers that has come to them. When you have experienced all powers, they become part of your life, like your limbs. Are you living here having become a mind of maximum experience? The father is perfect, and so his children have to become equal to their father. Therefore, there should be no defects. Achha, Bab Dada meeting a group of sevadaris. Sevadaris are equal to the father because He also comes here as the servant. The father's form is that of the world's servant. Just as the father is the world's servant, so all of you are also world's servants. Through your bodies, you are doing physical service, but through your minds, you remain engaged in the service of world transformation. You are sevadharis, serving with both your bodies and your minds. You are doing both types of service at the same time. It isn't that when you are serving through the body, you are unable to serve through your mind. By doing both types of service at the same time, you will receive double the attainment. Double servers become doubly crowned. If you only do one type of service, you cannot receive two crowns. While you are doing anything, check that you are not only doing one type of service instead of doing both types. When you pay attention in this way, you will develop this samskar. When you serve simultaneously with your body and mind, others will experience you to be an alaukik shakti. They will then automatically follow you. Now practice this and increase it. Increase this practice so much that it becomes your natural and constant practice. Acha, blessing, may you be an image and a great donor who grants blessings, the same as the Father, and claim blessings and give donations at the time of Brahma Murat. Description: at the time of Brahma Murat, the Father who is a resident of Brahma Lok especially gives children as a blessing the rays of light and might of the Sun of Knowledge. Together with this, Father Brahma, as bestower of fortune, distributes the nectar of fortune. Simply, let the urn of your intellect be worthy of holding the nectar. Let there not be any type of obstacle or obstruction. You will then be able to start the day with an auspicious beginning for an elevated stage and actions. Because the atmosphere at Amrit Vela can change the attitude. This is why, while claiming blessings at that time, you must also donate them. That is, be an image that grants blessings and a great donor too. Slogan: it is the duty of an angry person to get angry, whereas your duty is to give love. Om Shanti.